Humbie man, a soul flow man, come make with reason with intelligence.
Hunger flag, how can you do this? Whoa, 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 soul flow. Soul flow, me shock your eye. Set that beat, father. Set that beat, yeah. Hey, soul flow, your king turn up loud, and all the boy. Hey, soul flow.
Soul flow, turn up the team. How is the productivity and progress, you know? Up.
Welcome to Soul Flow TV again, everybody. It's your host with the most. So my bags are packed and I am on my way out the door. Heading to Texas again. Just picked up a contract, finalized another contract. For those of you who've been here on Soul Flow TV for a while, you know that my field of employment is actually occupational therapy and it's not YouTube. Even though I'm doing pretty well on YouTube and I'm starting to like it so much, I'm thinking I want to put occupational therapy on the back burner and pursue this YouTube thing at a full-time level along with other things. But that's a whole nother video. That's not what we come to talk about today. I'm just letting you know that I'm getting ready to go on the road. So things might become a little sparse. You won't be getting the 2-3 videos per day like you normally do. But for those of you who've been around again, you know how it is when I travel, right? And I certainly do make up for it in appreciation and giving you quality content when I get back home. Now, today we're going to talk about this latest headline out of Jamaica. It seems like for the past couple of days or weeks, it's just been killing after killing after killing, and it's men, Jamaican men, killing their women, whether they were killing them overseas or they were killing them in Jamaica itself. And this is something that no matter how we slice this cake, we still have to look at it for what it is. So today's headline will come with an urgent message from myself. But I'm going to read the story first. Then I want every Jamaican man, every Caribbean man, and every black man across the world, whether you're Jamaican, Caribbean, or otherwise, to listen and hear what it is I'm about to say. This is a warning to you, and I hope you don't miss it, because missing this might cost you your life. I'm going to say it again. Missing this might cost you your life. Check it out. Today's new report. Woman allegedly stabs her common-law husband to death in Manchester. Jamaica, my place, Manchester, Clarendon, Borderland, Manchester, you know, them round there, so anywhere around them kind of part there and place there, those are my place, right? Them, they are my place. So anyway, a woman allegedly stabbed to death her common-law husband, thanks to the loop for this one, in Woodlands, Manchester on Thursday morning. The deceased had been identified as 38-year-old farmer O'Neill Coleman. Police report that around 7 a.m. Coleman and his common-law wife were involved in a dispute at home when Coleman was stabbed in the neck after allegedly beating his partner with a machete. We say machete. I don't know if town people say machete. I was too little when I was living in town to remember if I say machete. But in a country where I grew up, we say machete, right? But overseas, where I've completed the rest of my growing up, they say machete. So here's this man beating this woman with a machete. What has possessed thou? What has given you the authority to? This is somebody's daughter. A machete, that's what you want to beat a female with, right? And she stabbed his ass in his neck and he died on the spot. The woman is now in custody. She's in police custody. Both the deceased and the accused had made reports about each other in the past for varying reasons, according to the police. Watch the video below. Shows the scene in the Woodlands on Thursday morning as residents in the rural community gathered some meters away from the cordoned off crime scene where Coleman was killed. And here, Loop has provided us with the video. I'm not going to play the video of you seeing some people gathered in the neighborhood around the area cordoned off. That won't do you any good. If you want to see it, go check out the Loop, okay? Loop brings credible news, and I've called them out like 2 years ago or a year and a half ago on a mistake they made, and they corrected it right away. So I know that they are credible. SoFlo TV would not send this audience anywhere that is not credible. So Loop News, look them up and go look this up. It was just the last fatal domestic violence case in the country. The latest fatal domestic violence case in the country. Last weekend, we had the woman constable, Melissa Edwards White, who was chopped to death by her husband at the couple's Farmbrook Avenue home in Patrick City. Earlier this week, in Rosemont, St. James, you had a 45-year-old gas station supervisor, Diane Smith, and her 16-year-old daughter, Jaishanelle Garden, who were both stabbed to death by throats cut like they were friggin' goats by her common-law husband, Fabian, who committed suicide after by driving into the Rio Mina River. And let's not forget about the other one that happened in Georgia, in the USA. Both Jamaicans. A man that she married and brought to the US ended up being her killer. So, with all this going on in such a short period of time, such a short space of time, I feel the urgency to bring you this message. Let me tell you something, right? And I want every black man, every Jamaican man, especially Jamaican men, because, I mean, I'm not saying that only Jamaican men are like this. Someone said, SoFlo TV, please tell me that not all Jamaican men are like this, because you make it sound like all Jamaican men are like this, and you are a Jamaican man yourself. Must I do this? And I hate to call people dunce, but must I do this? I understand there are new people coming to the channel who have not seen the older videos, and I would advise you to go watch my older videos before you make this generalized perception of me, okay? I've always stood up and I've always spoke about the men that raised me. They're all Jamaican men. Not one of them have killed a female. Not one of them have done any of the things close to any of this right here. Right? I'm talking about honorable men. They taught me how to be a man, how to be a protector, how to be a provider, how to take a heartbreak, how to love a woman, how to walk away if you love the woman and she hurts you anyways without harming her, how to get another good woman and continue with life. I learned those valuable lessons from Jamaican men. So yes, not all of us are like that. But in today's society, it seems like there are a lot of these sensitive-ass men that are prone to killing the women. And they're killing their women over simple things, things that could be avoided. My message to you is this, especially you Jamaican men. Let me tell you something. You're hot shit, right? You're the toughest thing, you're the baddest thing, you're a big man, you're a bad man. Nobody can tell you nothing when you're ready, your head hot. Yeah? Everything that you could think of, your woman, she is that too. You hear me? Everything you could think of, your woman, she is that too. She is that too, or she can become that too. In other words, the same warrior blood that runs through your veins that makes you stand tall and walk so proud is the same blood that runs through her veins and beats her heart and functions her brain. She carries the same warrior spirit. I have never seen a man more mutilated in life than a man that was exacted revenge upon by a Jamaican woman. One of my stories is, and I don't remember, but if you look it up on YouTube, I'm sure you can find it, because this brother was on Oprah Winfrey before Oprah Winfrey went off. He's a high-ranking soldier in the U.S. Army, but he has a Jamaican background, and he went back home and he married a Jamaican girl. Apparently, he took this Jamaican girl in, right? And he fails to tell his story about the part that he went schizo on her and used to like beat her up and all these kind of things. Anyway, she waited till he went to sleep one night and she just kindly stood over him and poured the battery acid all over him. And it chewed away his entire face. And if you ever chew up a piece of bubble gum and then pull it out wet and look at it dripping, that is exactly what his face looked like when he came on Oprah. I'm just trying to tell you that these women are not going to stand for this for much longer. And for those of you who are dumb enough to actually beat these women and then beat them in this kind of manner, like you're beating somebody's daughter with a friggin' machete, a long blade that you use to cut grass and sugarcane and tree limbs and stuff. You could kill this woman, chop her up, but you're skilled enough to beat her with the flat side and not the sharp side, right? You dumb idiot. She's not going to take that for much longer, man. There's another one that boiled the cooking oil. People, if you're in my comment section or if you're in my channel and you're a subscriber, and know my people are going to remind you in the comment section. So you got to read these comments and interact with each other. That's why I have this platform. That's why I dedicated myself to building this platform.
All right, so our campaign has kicked off for our Strength of a Nation campaign. All right, make sure you support our Strength of a Nation campaign by buying one of these beautiful pieces that you see in this video right here. $1 from every sale will go towards our charity of choice. And our charity of choice is forjamaica.org. Go look them up. In case you're wondering how to purchase one of these beautiful pieces, on every video on SoFlow TV, look right underneath the video and you will see a piece of merchandise. Click that and purchase directly right here on YouTube. Thanks in advance.
So we can come here and share our differences of opinions and share our opinions and share what we know, our little bit of knowledge, and put it together and make something, right? There's another one that boiled that friggin' cooking oil until it was bubbly hot and gave him a good massage after a hot bathtub she set for him and put him to sleep nicely and just poured that hot cooking oil all over him, face first, chest and all. And the other one that did it on his private parts, burnt it off. So I'm trying to tell y'all that these women are not going to take that much longer. And yes, there are women that have been fighting back. And the media always makes it seem like it is so drastic. She stabbed her common law husband to death. What has he been doing to her? Women don't just get up and stab up the man that them love to death. A woman is a very emotional creature. And I'm not doing this to side with women. And I want my men to understand that. But any real man out there that's watching this knows this. Unless she is a total schizo, which you should have picked up from day one, there's no woman out there that loves a man, right? And then one day out of the blue, just get up and just stab you up for no reason. There are things that you've been doing to this woman. And man, some people say walk away, but I have seen in my lifetime the extent of where this goes. And I cannot say that I can just agree with that. Like, for instance, there are men out there. Okay, let me talk real. I grew up in Jamaica, right? Partially. And I saw where women were beaten and dragged down the street because man come home from work and dinner not on the table when he gets in the house. Man come home from work and the baby them, the picnic them, the children, they're not bathed and dressed how he wanted them to be, and things aren't in place how he wants it to be. And man come home from work, and like, I've seen so many different aspects and none of it is justifiable. But the kind of lengthy ass beating and the drastic measures of beating I've seen women taken in Jamaica. And here's the sad part. I've seen the community gather around to watch the beating, and they weren't cheering, but they weren't stopping it either. They would more stand around and say like, all right, John, stop now, John, oh God, John, don't thump her like that, John. But nobody was, and the poor woman, they're there frailing her arms barely to save her face and to save herself, and he's here wrap up and full uppercut and bust up face and drag down the street. These women aren't going to take that. My Jamaican men, I don't know if you know your history, but Marcus Mosiah Garvey said, if you don't know your past, you don't know your future. In other words, if you don't know where you're coming from, you'd have no idea where you're going. You probably don't even have any idea where you're at now. You're a lost individual, yeah? So when we want to hail up all the warriors, hail up the woman warriors too, because they were the fiercest. Do y'all remember Nanny? Nanny of the Maroons? Okay. Some of them Jamaican women here, or most of them, they have that Nanny bloodline. They have that Nanny spirit in them. So don't think you're going to abuse her like that for the longest and get away with it. Eventually, you're going to pay. Yeah? So I see people bawling and crying and, oh God, she never have to kill him. You have no idea what that woman had endured. And I'm not trying to make no difference between this and, say, for instance, the incident that happened in Georgia with the Jamaican couple. That incident, I've had the pleasure of actually talking to more than one family member of that female. Yeah? And I've had the pleasure of also seeing my name being slandered by members of the male's family. Soul Floor TV over here going like him know the full story. You know, like them boy, they don't go chat off them mouth and them not really know and all that. I'm free for you to contact me. You could contact me and say, hey man, listen, my brother was going through a lot. He never ever cheated on her. You could have called me and said all that. But instead, what you're gonna do? Try to justify more the reason why. And then shift blame to me. I'm a commentator. I commentate on anything. If the bird fall off the friggin' wire outside and shit on the ground, I comment on that. If I feel like it's interesting. Of course, I don't know the full story. So don't come at it like that. Come at it trying to tell your loved one's side of the story. This boy dashed away his life, but he ended her life. And he changed forever the life of her children and her remaining family members that loved her, cared for her. Yeah? So it's crazy. It's crazy. And the sad thing about this is there are a lot of Jamaican men that are going to watch this. And not only Jamaican men, black men, period, from any part of the Caribbean or any part of the world. Because they all a lot of them tune into SoFlo TV now, and they're not Jamaican. You're going to watch this, and then you're going to go back right to your ways tomorrow. Or you're going to give it a 2-day break, and you're going to go right back to beating her again, right back to dragging her again, demeaning her again. And I'm telling you, you better be careful, because just like this brother in the story right here, you might wake up with a hot one in your neck. You might wake up to your face being peeled off by some battery acid. You might wake up to some good hot oil. You might wake up a way you don't want to wake up. To her credit, she carries the same bloodline as you. Do you hear what I'm saying? Go look up your history, man. It helps to know your history. Learn about Nanny. Learn about Queen Izinga. Learn about these African female warriors that run through these women's bloodline. They're not to be taken lightly. They're strong as hell. They take a lot just because they're strong. They take stuff that we can't take. Yo, Jamaican men are known for, or Caribbean men are known for this. One bag of woman. And I was speaking to my wife about that earlier today, and the different dynamics of why we come to that. Right? Like, we need to have one bag of woman and all this thing. We're womanizers, and it makes us feel big and proud and big badge upon chest, and you are the man and everything like that. And we expect to have that one woman at the house that goes through all that. Your charades, your accolades, by all your fans, females and males, cheerers. And you don't expect this lady to feel any kind of way. And the minute she see one brother what she thinks she like, and she say, you know what? He been doing this to me all along, breaking my heart, hurting me, I've been giving him my all. If you even think that she liked that brother, you don't even have to have proof that she did anything. You just gotta think that she like him. Or sight her one day, say, hi, how you doing? And all hell break loose. You wanna kill her and everybody else that she knows. So these women are strong. They put up with a lot. Yeah? They put up with a lot to bear our, and bore and bear. Bore our children and our families. And hold us together like glue. So we can look back in our latter years and say, yeah, you know how far away I come from, and look for me picking them all, them are the good, and she give me that one I know, and watch him now, and watch her now, and these kind of things. It is through them and their womb and their decisions. So we have to treat them different than how we're treating them. The sad thing is, black people on a whole in the Western world are in a deplorable condition. We're in a psychotic state. So we look at each other with no love. Whether it's male to male, because it's nothing for a black man to shoot down. I've been many places and I've seen almost every black man, except for if he's conscious. When he meets me in a room, his posture and his facial expressions are immediately defensive. It's I'm grilling you. What? Give me eye contact. I bet you can't hold my stare. I have no problem hurting you. And we treat our women the same damn way. The same way. She's to be used and discarded. And then we pick up another one and we do the same thing. And we continue the cycle. And we damage a whole bunch of them from younger age all the way up to elderly. And then we think that this is going to better our future generation when we're having seeds from damaged women. We're doomed in the future and we're doomed now. And I hope my brothers hear this message, man. And I'm gonna close this video by saying this again. Be very careful, especially you beaters and abusers. Be very careful. Because this right here, this ain't the first that this happened. A woman stabbed to death her common-law husband. This ain't the first that this happened. There are stories out there that I told you before that you might want to research and know that it can happen to you. Because she carries that same bloodline. She is a warrior. And when she starts to fight back, oh man. When she gets to the point where she actually scorns you, watch out. Alright? I'm gonna leave this video right here, man. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Leave your comment in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about this one. Tell me about any stories you know about black women that actually fought back in ways that were savage because she had to. So we can enlighten our brothers to, or at least deter from going down that path, because we don't want to see this no more. We don't want to see it no more. It does not look good at all. It's sad on all levels. I'm out. Peace.